But do you hear again? Messages 1 and 2 at least have a sequence. Lead with value, and then drop that offer beneath the fold. So now, in the sake of the cheat sheet that I'm giving to you here on that 32-page, broadcast number 3, now I've got the right, earn the right to make an offer, so then you can make the offer. Email number 3, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to lead with the offer. You know your business can change people's lives, but you don't yet have the right words to inspire them to take action. Imagine the changes you will create in your business as you tap into the secrets of ethical influence and positive persuasion to not only better serve your clients, but also to supercharge your financial freedom. I'm your host, Jason Linett, and welcome to the Hypnotic Language Hacks podcast. I help entrepreneurs and business owners just like you to close more premium sales. And no, this isn't about tricking or manipulating people, not at all. It's about helping your prospects to appropriately sell themselves into your products or services. Please hit subscribe and get all the episodes now at jasonlinett.com. Welcome back. It's Jason Linett. This is episode number 32, Send Emails, Make Money. Now, that title, Send Emails, Make Money, I should probably let you know ahead of time what other titles I went through before making it simple and going with those simple four words. First draft was How to Send Emails That Don't Piss People Off. How about that? The other one was How to Do Email Marketing in a Way That People Don't Hate You. Now, those were kind of long for a podcast episode, so instead we've made it simple. This week is all about Send Emails, Make Money. Let me give you a heads up ahead of time here, too. There is a free resource that goes along with this week's episode. If you head over to jasonlinett.com/32, the number 32, that'll redirect you over to the show notes of this week's episode where you can get the Send Emails, Make Money cheat sheet. Before we get started today, if you want to easily grab people's attention, naturally build authority, and organically have your prospects wanting more from you, even before you've made an offer, I've created a step-by-step program to help you to do just that. It's called Business Influence Systems. And this is your opportunity now to visit jasonlinett.com to get a free behind-the-scenes tour of the exact hypnotic persuasion strategies that you can ethically use to better start up or scale up your business. If you want a proven framework to boost your confidence, attract premium clients, and inspire more people to take action with you, get Business Influence Systems now at jasonlinett.com. Now, before I jump into this week's episode, for those of you tracking the personal story, as of right now, I'm still recording in North Carolina, and can you hear my fingers currently crossing? We are on our way down to Florida, where the family is moving to, and by the time this episode drops, should be down there, but hey, stay tuned. Let's see what happens. Let me set the stage for you in terms of the content of this week's episode, because this was inspired by an email from a friend of mine who's up in Pennsylvania. And basically, he sent me a message, which I'll read segments of here in a moment. But basically, what he was asking was, how is it that you do this and it works for you, but when I've tried it, it didn't work for me? And as soon as I responded and explained what may have been missing from his email promotion, he goes, yeah, that's it. Let me read you a bit of a paraphrase of this message. Jason, I'm curious to know if you get negative pushback from the frequency of how many emails you send out promoting workshops and podcasts. I ran an announcement of an online workshop last fall. After an initial positive response, the first 5 or 6 days, interest tapered off after 2 weeks. By the fourth week, I had people requesting their contact information be removed. Do you keep metrics on the responses based on how often and how long an announcement runs? Now, I'm going to give you some formulas inside of this, but I'll give you the overview of what I sent to this individual first. And by the way, once again, jasonlinett.com/32. I'm going to give you the cheat sheet that I'm going to be working off of inside of this week's episode. That's going to be available to you as a free download from that show notes page. The basic idea is this. I only ever want to send an email when I'm providing more value. Now, in terms of hypnotic language hacks, there's a principle in terms of hypnotic communication referred to as pacing and leading. Now, pacing is basically getting in sync with somebody. Leading is, as it would sound, leading to the next logical step. So as you're listening to this podcast and considering the concepts of email marketing and thinking about some of the promotions you may have done in the past, you might be realizing there's something to be learned in terms of how to do this even better. And some of you may be smiling who have been around me long enough, and some of you may be leaning in and going, what's going on? Let me explain. What I did there was I gave you three pacing statements. I fed back three things that were sensory verifiably true. And I did that just off the cuff there. But the basic format was, as you're listening to this podcast and thinking about email marketing and considering campaigns you may have done in the past, those were all things that we could verify as being true. Otherwise, you likely wouldn't still be listening. Or even inside of that, perhaps you're realizing that email marketing may be something that could be valuable to add to the shape of your business, which allowed me to then make a suggestion. The fourth one was a leading statement, realizing there's things you can learn to do this even better. So I give you this as a formula, because the idea is I only want to be sending another message if in some way I'm adding value. Let me pause for a moment here and give you one of my favorite marketing and business formulas. Invite your audience to care before you ever ask them to listen. So once again, invite your audience to care before you ever ask them to listen. Because here's where email marketing often gets a bit of a bad rap. And chances are, based on the exchange I had with this person, this might have been what he did too. Suddenly, out of nowhere, here's an offer. Suddenly, without any expectation, here's a promotion. And the reason why many people don't like email marketing is because there's far too many people who are doing it badly. And that tends to be a good safe formula around the world. Something gets a bad rap when a few people do it badly. I'd like you to do it goodly, or at least better. Let's use appropriate grammar here. So the mindset is, I want to lead with value. I want to share something of content first, and then just like that pacing and leading sequence, value, 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 offer. And then from here, we could start to play with the formula. Value, value, offer, offer. Then from here, we can keep going further. Value, offer, offer, offer. Now, once we've established that rhythm, now we've got rapport. Now we've created a relationship with our potential client, our prospect, our soon-to-be buyer, whatever line of business you may be in. But now we reach that place where we can appropriately lead, because again, invite your audience to care before you ask them to listen. Have you caught this before? Sometimes there's that person who apologizes for the offer that they're making. Earn the right to make an offer. And then once you've earned the right, then say it with pride, offer it with confidence, because again, it should be something that can make someone's life even better. So I'll give you a preview of what I'm about to talk to, which if this does sound technical, I'd encourage you pause the recording and head over to jasonlinett.com just for the folks that are curious. I have every misspelling of my last name as a website. So do your best to spell jasonlinett.com. But for those that are curious, L-I-N-E-T-T, one N, two T's, no extra letters at the end. jasonlinett.com/32. If some of what I'm about to get into sounds technical, it's actually quite simple. But if it seems a little too technical just to listen to, pause the recording, go get the cheat sheet from the page. You'll be right back on track here. But I want you to consider something that even I'm surprised about. There's a way that people have now, well, let's lay the foundation first. There's a way that people eventually find themselves on my email list. And I'll give you a few examples over the years. Well, first of all, did you catch? I just gave you an opportunity right now. The people who go to that page on my website, oftentimes we call this an opt-in offer. Some people call this a content upgrade. Some people call it the ethical bribe, whatever you want to call it. Here's the opportunity to get something by exchanging your email address. And the form basically does explain, by requesting this, you were also agreeing to receive additional content. And I'd encourage you, always use some sort of email automation system. The reason being that, first of all, I've got about 20,000 people on my combined mailing lists, and I respectfully don't have time to send those people email responses one by one at all hours of the day. So instead, here's an automated system that, you know, we've got a good following over in Australia and New Zealand. For those of you that it may be in the middle of the day, which is when I'm asleep, you can still hit jasonlinett.com/32, and you're going to get that resource on demand, even while I'm asleep. The other reason is this helps you to be better in compliance with traditional email marketing laws, rules, and regulations around the world. And like any good email automation system, every message has a little footer at the bottom that gives you the opportunity to perhaps update your email address if you ever change your email address, or unsubscribe if you find at some point it's not a match for you. So that's why I tend to encourage you use those softwares for the type of thing I'm talking about right now. Other examples, my book, Work Smart Business. When that came out in January of 2019, I'll be very open and say the book has sold quite well. And every month I get a nice little chunk of payment from the different royalty payments from Amazon as a result of the book Work Smart Business. The income from the book has been good. The attention and the relationships and the transactions as a result of people going through the book, that has been much better. So for those of you who have seen Work Smart Business, if not, head over to Amazon. You can track it down easily. Throughout the book, there are various opt-in offers. Here's a confidence audio program that people can request. And by requesting it, they're invited to be on my list. I give away the entire audiobook of the book itself. Rather than make you go to Audible and buy it after you've already bought the book, there's a link inside the book to actually get the free audio of the book. Similar to that too, we have the Business Influence and Persuasion Facebook group. And people who join that group are offered to share an email address to get a specific free training. So this is part of the strategy where over time, people end up in that general mailing list of people who have requested information from me. So have that in mind. Look for more opportunities to give more value and invite people to hear more from you. And I do tend to say, respectfully speaking, nobody wants your damn newsletter. And here's what I mean by that. Far too often, it's just the I'm going to mail you because it's Thursday. Instead, someone wanted to see the 11 secret words document. Somebody wanted to get the send emails, make money template that I'm going to be talking about here in a moment. Give a specific piece of value rather than just say, sign up for my newsletter. So this is where over time, by keeping this up over the last, what are we at now, 12, 13, or 14 years of business, this is how I have the mailing list, the community, the following that I have. Likewise, here's the other podcast that I do specifically just inside of the hypnosis industry, which you can imagine having run that thing now for about 7 years, more than 1 million downloads. That's a very large mailing list as well. Oh, did you catch that? That's a different community than the Hypnotic Language Hacks community. Segment your content. Don't just blast anything and everything to everybody. There's your 5-minute crash course in building your email list over time. So here's where I want to kick this off in terms of send emails, make money. I want to introduce a template to you with 4 simple steps. And I'll tell you what's surprising about this to me is that inside of this formula, I will tell you that step 2 is a free resource that's usually accessible by way of a link. Click here to watch a video. Click here to go to this website. Click here to go read this news article. So some sort of free resource is step 2. Step 4 is the call to action of the offer. This is the click here to learn about the next class. This is here, here's the coupon code, the promotion code, whatever it might be. So here's the formula for broadcast email number 1. A resource preframe. I'm setting the stage for why what you're about to get access to is important. If it's perhaps a podcast episode like the one that you're listening to right now, I might begin with some of the same language that I've said to you so far. Many people find a frustration that they send emails and they don't get the response that they're looking for. When you learn how to put the right offers in the right order to the right audience, your results can change. That sounds good. We should write that down and use that for the email when this comes out. Click here to listen to this week's podcast episode. There's the resource link, which is step 2. So step 1, resource preframe. This is the intro. This is the tell them what you're going to tell them moment. Then from there comes the resource link. Then from there, traditionally in my systems, We may skip a line. We may even do a purple horizontal line because, well, did you hear last week's episode? But then from there, step three in this four-part sequence, and this is just the first email, by the way. Step three is the offer preview. Hey, we've got an event coming up all about this topic. I'm going to be covering X, Y, and Z. To learn more, please watch this video. And here comes step four, offer call to action. Let me walk through those four steps, by the way, once again. Resource preframe, resource link, offer preview, offer CTA. Now, I'll give you the details here in a moment, but for right now, we're talking about the first email of at least a 3, 4, or 5 email campaign, which right there, by the way, is often what people are missing. They send one email and hope people get it. If I'm going to send something out to my communities at times in terms of an offer, it's going to be sent at least 3 times. Not everybody is always looking at their devices. Most traffic nowadays is on mobile. Not everybody is looking at their devices when they're in a place where they can make a buying decision, which is the most polite way that I can say they're looking at their phone on the toilet. And with that, let's keep going here. So broadcast email number one, resource preframe, resource link, followed by offer preview, offer call to action, CTA. Here's what's interesting. The person who sent me the message asked about, do I keep metrics? What I'm about to tell you, even this surprises me. In terms of our email tracking, which any of the email automation systems can tell you this, I can see that most people click the offer call to action first. Then from there, they go back and they interact with the free resource. I want you to think about that for a moment. And I'm going to use some playful language around this to kind of mind read possibly what may be going on. I'm leading with goodwill. Now, mind you, I am not just sending out free content to build goodwill. I'm always looking at how can I get people small, quick wins. The same way that simply listening to this podcast episode, it's going to help you to rethink how you do your email marketing, realizing that one single email may not be enough, that it's a bit of a campaign over time. And clearly, toward the end of this episode, I'll explain. And if you need some influential patterns in terms of what to put in those emails, be sure to head over to jasonlinett.com and check out Business Influence Systems, my hypnotic writing course specifically for business. Do you see how organic that is now? As opposed to you turn on the podcast and suddenly, let me tell you what's in my program. That's when people tune out. Now, I want you to have these small, quick wins because, again, I want you thinking differently about your business. There are people out there that if they're not aware of you, you're not going to help them. They're going to be stuck inside of their problem even longer. And from an ethical standpoint, here's the inner dialogue that I often suggest. How dare you not make it easy for those people to find you? That's where all this comes from. But again, isn't that interesting? In a four-step email where the first half is a free resource, the second half is a call to action for a specific offer. The old terminology in terms of a newspaper of the content that was below the fold. What I've found is people scroll through the email and then they click towards the bottom in terms of the content. Then they come back to the email and then they engage with the resource. So do you see how people will scroll down, interact from the bottom, kind of like the what happens nowadays with a long form sales page, which yes, some people have opinions about that, but they clearly still work. And that's why we all still use them and teach them as well along the way. That again, if you dismiss the entire template, you're missing the point because you can pick and choose specific contents, and then that becomes the content for your email as well. So inside of the cheat sheet that I've got for you again over at jasonlinett.com/32, broadcast number one, resource preframe, resource link, offer preview, offer call to action. There's your formula, which again, the surprising thing, people will often scroll through. And because you got the foot in the door because of the free resource, they're going to stay with you. They're going to see your offer. And not everybody, mind you, but in my experience, a surprising amount will click for that call to action on the offer first. Now, keep in mind, not everybody's going to take action right away. Now, this is where I'll leave it to you in terms of what the promotion is. I'd give you the example that we had a class That's coming up in a couple of months, which by the time you hear this episode, this specific class is already sold out. So listen for the teaching metaphor of this, that we had 36 spots. And about a week before last week, at least, we had 10 spots available. Then all of a sudden, we sold like 9 spots and we had 1 spot left. And excuse me, because as of right now, there still was just 1 spot remaining. Just out of my curiosity, I have to peek at the moment. Yep. As of right now, at least the recording, 1 spot is still left. I guarantee you in the next, 16 days, that'll be gone. So disregard the specifics. Listen for the teaching example here. Now, this is where I had a reason to say 1 spot left as an email to the community. But again, people will go through that free resource. And this is what's building that goodwill. This is helping you to build rapport with people. Give them a couple of days and repeat now with broadcast number 2. Campaigning. Advertising is not an event, it's a sequence. So now, resource reminder. I cannot tell you how surprised I am how effective this is. And you want a subject line? Did you miss this? Reminder, free video. Reminder, free technique. Something to reiterate the thing that you've already iterated? Is that even the right word? But the opportunity now to once again remind people, did you get a chance to check this out? Now, here's a cool place to start to build some organic engagement. This is where you could ask, if you did get to listen to it, please hit reply and let me know your thoughts. If you have been able to use this technique, hit reply and let me know how it's working for you. Start to involve some engagement. But again, I want you to offer value from a genuine place that you are sincerely offering value and looking to make people's lives better. I'm operating from the best place. If I can be just as satisfied with the person who got the free resource and was wonderfully successful, as happy as I am with them, as the person who goes high ticket with me and spends some time and we do some longer consulting. So broadcast number 2, resource reminder. As simple as that. Do you hear how I'm repurposing my own content here? To which, once again, resource link. We're staying within the lead with value first formula, at least for the first 2 emails. And now, part 3, offer with more detail. This is where perhaps the previous one wasn't too heavy on the details of the offer. But maybe in the second email in the campaign, I might hit them with a bullet list. And those of you already inside of business influence systems have seen all the formulas around successful writing, around influential bullet points. Similar to that too, this is where I might drop some testimonials. This is where I may share some further resources that are specifically, let's say, on a sales page. It's up to you if you market with promotion codes or not. It's also up to you if you're marketing with a specific deadline or a countdown. But this is where I'm going to be a little bit more detailed in terms of the second email, because again, message number 1, the foot is in the door. Message number 2, the step is widened. And now I'm looking to advance that relationship because now I've got a little bit more permission to make an offer. Wrap it up with that seed A. By the way, as well, make sure whatever system you're using, if you're just starting out, you may have to do this manually, but it is within good form. Remove people from the sequence once they take action. This is a little nuance that I've made it a point of every aspect of my business ever since I started. Stop trying to sell people things that they've already purchased from you. It's a little nuance I learned the hard way. There's an amazing marketing convention that I've made it a point to go to every year until, you know, pandemic. And I would still continue to get their emails promoting the conference. And I mean, like, not like here's who's going to be there, but instead the next pricing tier is going to change. And I'm getting these ads, even though I've paid to attend. And from that, I learned list segmentation, remove people out. If you're using a more robust system, like perhaps I use Infusion Soft, there's Ontraport, you can do this with Kartra, you can do this with all sorts of more advanced systems. You can set up stop tags. So basically, once someone buys, they're taken out of the sequence. But do you hear again, messages 1 and 2, at least of a sequence, lead with value, and then drop that offer beneath the fold. So now, in the sake of the cheat sheet that I'm giving to you here on that 32 page, broadcast number 3, now I've got the right, earn the right to make an offer, so then you can make the offer. Email number 3, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to lead with the offer. I'm going to lead with more detail about the offer, more testimonials, perhaps more of a checklist, maybe a little bit of a case study inside of one specific part of whatever the program would be, and then specific call to action, and then if it's appropriate, some sort of countdown, some bit of appropriate scarcity. I say appropriate scarcity as I have my text messages open on my computer at the moment, and there's a person I had been messaging going, I really don't like false scarcity in marketing, or really just scarcity in general, because too many people do the false scarcity. Oh, there's one spot left, and then they pop up and go, we found 10 more spots. True story. There's a conference, which this might be why I didn't speak at it. There was a conference that was promoting, everybody, we found 5 more spaces. We can fit more people. And then you saw the photos of the event, and it was this giant ballroom space with like 22 people. Getting caught with your hand in the cookie jar, huh? So again, lead with value, lead with integrity, tell the truth. Mark Twain, the man who tells the truth, doesn't have to remember what he said. So broadcast number 3, now I've earned the right to lead with more of the offer. Now I've earned the right to go a little bit more direct to that call to action and maybe even hint at the appropriate honesty of a scarcity or a countdown factor. Give it a few days, and then here comes broadcast number 4. Again, I'd say for an email sequence, think in terms of 3, 4, or 5 emails. This is what's missing from a lot of people's thinking in terms of email marketing. They think just once, then they sit back and nothing happens, and then they go, that didn't work. That's what happens. The same as I was having a quick exchange with a person I'm doing business with right now. I'm the client, actually. And I just had to say, you've asked me 3 times for this resource that I've already given you. You know, they needed me to fill out a worksheet for part of what we're doing together. So not everybody flags their emails. Not everybody goes back and reviews it. So you are politely reminding them with the format that I'm sharing with you here. And then here comes broadcast number 4. This is going to sound familiar. Offer detail and proof. Then from there, hit your call to action a little bit harder. So we begin with a softer offer, and then toward the end, maybe it's a little bit more direct. There's one spot left. The price is increasing tonight at 10 p.m. You know, this promo code goes away. This free bonus workshop is only for the people who sign up by this date. Whatever way you do it, I'm going to be hitting that softer at the beginning of the sequence. And I don't want to say harder, but let's say a little bit more directly toward the end, which right here, I want you to hear what may be different from what you've done up until now. It's not just about sending out offers. It's about sending out messages that respectfully train people to want to receive your content. Put your personality inside of what you do. And yes, indeed, use influential language, which if you need more on that, head over to jasonlinett.com, check out Business Influence Systems. We'd love to have you inside of that community. Once more, I'll mention jasonlinett.com/32 because this is a really easy to digest 1-page PDF cheat sheet that I've made available to you so you can see exactly what this looks like, which consider this again, the mindset as we often say here, frameworks equal freedom. This is a starting point. Your campaign might have 2 or 3 emails. It might have 4 or 5. We have one campaign running somewhere in my system that runs for about 14 days and sends about 10 messages. But the rule is it continuously adds even more value, which as long as we're adding value, I have a right to continue to repeat that offer. So I want to hear what you do with this. Also, there on the show notes page is the link to our Business Influence and Persuasion community. All over on Facebook, we've got several hundred members from all around the world where we keep this dialogue going even long after the episode releases. So put this into use. Love to hear what you do with it. You have been listening to the Hypnotic Language Hacks podcast with Jason Linett. Please stop everything and start exploring jasonlinett.com for even more business influence and persuasion resources. Make it a priority right now to subscribe to this program and listen to every episode, because the next one may reveal that one hypnotic influence secret to massively scale your success. Change your words, change your business, change your life. Get even more at jasonlinett.com.